Hi guys, what's up? Today I'm going to show you how to install the Octane for Blender. I noticed that a lot of people ask me how to do that, and they say that seems a little bit complicated to install and set everything up. Okay. So let's take a look on the Autoy website. First, what you need to do is do the sign in. If you don't have an account, you have to create one. Okay, so go to the register a new account and set up your data over there and then sign in to be able to download the free tier from Octane. Okay, so after that, you have to go to this link, renderautoy.com. This link I will leave on the description down below, so you'll be able to access it from there. Okay, also to keep update on new features, new Octane release, I recommend you to go to the Facebook webpage and join us on the Octane, oops, Octane Render Blender plugin. Okay, so let me see this one. Okay, so here you're going to be updated on every feature or any problem that people are facing. So it's very important you join us on this group as well. And also Lino Grandi, this guy over here, is the responsible, I think, to release and post the link for the new release. So it's a good thing like to keep your eyes open on this channel, okay? So let's go and let's download Octane and install it. So I think I don't have this version, so I'll be doing it from the beginning. So what you need to do is download the Blender edition and also the Octane server. So I have to download this just two links. Okay, so I have Windows here, so I have to just press Windows and Windows for Octane server. And then after downloaded, you have like these two guys over here, and then you have to install the Blender Octane first. Or I don't think that has a order to do that, but by the way, I always like install Blender Octane Edition first. Okay, I'll install the Blender Edition. Okay. Finish and then install the Octane server as well. Another thing that's very important is to install all the latest drivers from NVIDIA. Okay, so let's go to the folder where it was installed. So it's somewhere over here, Blender Octane. Okay, so this is where Octane install the new version. So I have several ones already installed here. Okay, and the other thing that's important to know is you have to activate the Octane server. So let's look for it. Octane server prime, this one, and you have to click on it. And then you're going to see that this little icon over here is deactivated, and you have to double click on it and activate it. I don't know if it is going to ask me to sign in, but because I was already like working with Octane before, I had already like login previously. But otherwise, if it's your first time, probably you have to activate it. Just close it. So you're going to see the Octane server icon is still there, and it's important that it keeps there, because if actually all the time, every time that you start the Windows, you have to activate the Octane server. So let's go to the Blender software. And go to the edit preference, and let's activate the add-on Octane. Just type Octane and activate it. Perfect. And then if you go to the render settings, you're going to see that Octane is over there. And then it's done. Just press render, and yeah, working like a charm. If you have any questions regarding or any problem regarding the install or anything, I really recommend, if you want to leave me a message, it's okay, I try to help, but I really recommend you go to the Facebook channel Octane Render Blender plugin and post your doubts over there. It's important like for everybody to know what's going on and see if like the problem is just not for you and like for everybody. So yeah, thanks a lot, guys. Hope you enjoy it, and see you in the next video.